So, unang-una, why are we hosting SEA Games? Well, a multi-sport game like this, Mr. Speaker, I'll go to the foundation right away. The multi-sport event like this is a matter of national pride. It focuses on our people, it focuses on our culture, it benefits us in tourism, foreign investment. Sports tourism alone is $620 billion industry, which we want to tap into. So question, are we spending a lot of money? Yes. Is it excessive? No. Is it overpriced? No. Singapore spent $15 billion in hosting alone in 2020.
With all due respect, we never said that this was overpriced.
Yes, sir. So, I'm referring to the news report,
so that's why, may we request that the honorable speaker respond to the questions that we raise so that we don't go astray in our discussion.
So I'll just go to that because these are questions that, Mr. Speaker, that the minority leader either asked or, as you said, news reports. But just one more minute with your indulgence.
No?
So Malaysia spent $7 billion on hosting alone, $15 billion in sports development, and $1.5 billion to upgrade the facilities. RC Games will be the biggest in history, the most number of sports. We expect 1 billion viewers. The cauldron that has been put in the spotlight is cheaper than what was built by Singapore in the last 4 years. 4 years ago, $63 million. And yung sa Singapore po, hindi po national artist. Why? Because the cauldron po is the symbol. It's not one of the symbols. It's the symbol of the games, whether it's Olympic Games or SEA Games, and it's a work of art. So while some people may see a cauldron, we see a monument, we see the athletes, we see the burning flames that represent hope and the fighting spirit. So we think it was just appropriate, in the same manner that the Senate yesterday moved to increase the budget of CPP by $40 million to be $50 million para sa Philharmonic, it's the same manner we support that, and we will support that in the BICAM. So to your question, Mr. President, why a foundation? Because it's the SEA Games Federation that owns the games. And all SEA Games are run by foundations. So in the IOC rules and the SEA Game Federation rules, it's either the Olympic Committee, but they will form a foundation that will be the organizing committee, or it could be a multi-stakeholder. But in all games, so in 1991, we had MANSOC, which was a foundation. And if I'm not mistaken, at that time, sir, you were Secretary of Justice. And in 2005, I think, sir, you were Senate President, we had PhilSoc. It was also a foundation. In Singapore, they had SingSoc. In Malaysia, they had MASOC. So yung OC po dun, sir, is always organizing committee. So thank you, sir, for asking that because that's been a lingering question. But we had no choice. If we don't want a foundation, we cannot host the games.